Hi guys, so glad you tuned into our nodes tutorial. We're going to cover the node tool itself, but also node characteristics, styles, behaviors, as well as editing paths. In our previous pen tool episode, which you can watch in the upper right corner or down below, we learned how to create simple shapes like this antenna, or more complex ones like this butterfly wing. But after creating something with the pen tool, it's very likely that you'll want to edit your path. Nothing is perfect on the first try. This is what the node tool is for. If you select an object using this tool, you can see all its nodes. But if you want to actually select nodes, you need to either tap them individually or drag your stylus across the canvas. And now all node handles become visible. But let's zoom in here to see what's happening. You'll notice that nodes have different colors, and there's, of course, a very good reason for that. But let's go back to the simpler shape. It's a disconnected path, which makes it easier to understand what's under the hood. The start node is green, the middle nodes are blue, and the endpoint is red. How is that helpful? Well, this property becomes particularly useful in a closed shape. Let me select it again, so you guys can notice the start and end points here. If you want to open the shape with our Open Shape button, the path will always disconnect between the first and last nodes. Now let's focus on the anatomy of a node. Each and every node has two handles, which take very different angles and lengths. Some are short, some are long, and some go in the same direction. That is because there are four node types, which you can find in the Content Aware option at the top of the Style tab, which appears when a node or a shape is selected with the Node tool. Simply tap on an anchor point using the Node tool, and you'll notice that its type is highlighted. So let's go through them one by one. The node types are single, symmetric, or mirrored, asymmetric, and disconnected. Let's select another node to see what type it is. Notice that it's the same as the previous. It's an asymmetric node. This means that the handles are opposing each other, but I can control them individually. So one can be shorter while the other can be longer. In the case of a mirrored node, as the name suggests, the handles take on the same length no matter which one you pull, making them perfect for creating symmetrical curves. This here is a disconnected node. Both the handle's length and angle can be controlled individually, so they no longer oppose each other. This type of node is really helpful for creating deep, curved angles. Lastly, a single node does not have any handles, and it's a node that creates very sharp corners and cannot create curves. But let's see this more closely while learning a gesture at the same time. If we select this node, we notice it's asymmetric, but if we double tap it, it transforms into an angular type. How do we know? It has no handles and a very angular shape. The Style tab also confirms it. By double tapping it again, the node turns back to asymmetric, and you can change its shape in accordance to asymmetric node behaviors. But that is just one way to edit a path. You can also change your path by adding extra nodes, which you can do by simply tapping anywhere on the path between two points. This gives you a lot more control over its shape. And you can delete nodes too, which you can do by selecting one or multiple nodes and hitting this button up here. The shape can change pretty dramatically, as you can see. That's it for today. There's a lot more gestures and shortcuts within the app, which we'll cover in a separate video. So stay tuned for that one. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you soon.